hits your eye like a big pizza pie. That's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing Vita Bella. Hearts will play, tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a guitarandella.
Welcome to the show tonight. Yes, this is not one of the typical episodes of pizza. What it is tonight is a documentary on how we make the fantastic show that has done everything's made us rich, beaten the ratings, had the tip-top success that it's had. And I'm going to take you through it. If you don't know me, you're obviously a stooge. I'm Paulie, and I am the director and producer and the writer of the show. Killing chef Bobo, it's all true. Sleek, the Lebanese rapper, they were the inspiration for a lot of them stories. And we've become rich, all the three of us, me, Bobo, and Sleek. You know, he still he actually thinks that he's a good musician. We better cut that bit out, but we'll just start again.
Mate, you've done a good job directing, eh? Yeah, but listen, man, I'm one of them girls naked.
Huge, man. I've got this huge house. It's so huge. I haven't even been in every room. And I've got all these cars. I've got all these chicks. I've got this. I've got that. I've got everything, man.
I guess my point is, we are rich, and that's good.
Fat pizza pizzas. They're big and they're choosy.
What's on a ham and pineapple?
How did I know that the TV show was a success? Everywhere I went, people were stopping me, wanting autographs, wanting, you know, ask me about Paulie and Sleek and about Fat Pizza.
Because I want you to talk about some of the characters in the show. Now, what would be your description of a character, like, say, Habib?
Wog.
And, like, if we talked about, say, Sleek?
Wog. Short Wog.
Yeah, you can talk about my character, Paulie, but, you know, you want to just mention all the talent champion boxing, all that.
Talented champion boxer, talented champion gambler, talented champion director, short wog, hairy.
No, we just cut that.
Garlic breath.
No, hold on. No, we'll just change the question now.
Well, I thought you wanted everything.
Yeah, well, just the good stuff.
Oh, okay.
Just the good stuff, because, you know. Well, anyway, you know, we know you're a good looking model. We know. Just don't pull that trip on me now.
Hold it, man.
G'day, this is Habib from the Pizza Launch. We have many characters here.
What does Habib mean?
Habib means darling in Lebanese.
Darling.
Yeah. Now, you were stuck in a house, right, for 10 weeks. You weren't allowed to go anywhere, and they filmed this, right? But in my culture, that happens all the time.
The lady stays in the house.
You're a Habib?
That's me.
Am I a Habib?
You are a definite Habib.
Habib, hey. Habib, hey, Habib. Oh, come on, Habib.
Well, look, it brings back a few memories being here.
Yeah, bro.
So, you know, this is it. This is the old shop. This is where it all started, you know. It looks much better now that Bobo has sold it. So, you know, for the people who are not famous and didn't start from the humble beginnings like us, sucked in, because we've done it and you haven't. Yeah. What can I tell you, mate?
That's come on, man, don't be like that.
No, deep
down, we're all still the same people. He's still got no idea and doesn't know how to treat people. He's still lost, trying to find himself. And I am, as I always have been, always will be.
Sleek, mate, you're so ignorant. You're at your hokey philosophising.
Man, Bobo looks like a loser. The other pizza guy looks like some sort of child abuser. Sleek, the elite, I'm not used to this type of thing. Word to the letter. I had a bad night tonight, but things will get better.
You know, so I'm going to take you through, slowly, about how the whole show happened. Let's go back to the beginning, you know. Originally, me, myself, and Bobo, and Sleek, we actually did work in a real pizza shop. We were pizza guys. We were the bums that, you know, you used to ring up and say, hey, you know, I want my margarita and we'd come and then you'd give us like all the change, or you wouldn't have the change, or you'd want to use the credit card. We were guys like that, mate.
Do you want me to come in?
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah!
Anyway, what happened was, I worked for Bobo for many years, and I had enough, you know, because the real Bobo...
Shut up!
And, like, the screen Bobo that you see, there's not much difference, you know? So I had enough, you know, I worked there for 10 years, that's enough for me, time to move on. And I did a good career move, I got a job at SBS as a cleaner. And I was working here for a little while, and I started to see all these people had these jobs. I thought, what are these people doing, you know? Well, what's that, Blake Show? Basically, there was all these people walking around doing like nothing but getting paid top dollar. And I thought to myself, if I can get in on this scam, this will be good. One day, I was cleaning the toilets here. This is the toilet area where I was cleaning. And, you know, I was mopping this area here. It was very slippery in that. And I was doing the mopping, and I just went outside to get a sandwich. And what's happened is this bloke, this executive who used to work here, I think his name was Ben something, who cares, he's come out and he slipped on the slippery water, and his head, you know, he's hit that, and he was dead. So I hid the body. I mean, I shouldn't be saying this, but the legal case, it's all gone now. I was exonerated by the judge. I hid the body, and then I just took his place. You know, I just started coming into his office, and nobody noticed. This was this bloke's office. I've messed it up a bit since. It was much cleaner when I got in here. And so, you know, what I used to do, I'd come in and just sit, like, behind this desk here, and I just pretended to be this Ben, this TV guy. And the head of this place, this SBS, comes into me one day while I'm sitting there. I didn't know what I was doing. And he said, look, we need a new comedy show.
Ben, we need a new comedy for the shows. You should do it because you're one of them producers. We need it soon.
I'm thinking to myself, what kind of show could we do? What experience did I have? It hit me, the pizza thing, you know? The action, the chicks, all the stuff that we enjoyed in that pizza days. Man, like, that's the thing with the show. Everything that happens is based on a true story, you know? So I made a couple of these short little, what they call in television, they called them pilots. You know, the rest was history. The show was that good that they put it on air. And then it became like that famous, and now you're like, we're millionaires and stuff, you know. But basically, that's how it happened. It was all because of that bloke who slipped on the tiles. So what I would like to do now is preview and promo to the whole Australia. This was the first pizza film that was made. This wasn't like a TV show. This was just like the first one. I filmed it. I did the editing, the writing. I did everything, you know? So this is it.
So, Tony, what's been happening, mate? You're not looking too good. Man, the other night I had this most ridiculous, crazy night. You wouldn't believe it. Hey, I'm driving in a car. I get out delivering, you know, just it's another pizza, you know, nothing special, I'm thinking. I walk up to the door, knock on the door, and this guy comes out. He looks a little bit psycho. I mean, you can see something in his eyes. You know, sometimes you can see these guys. Anyway, you know, he pays me. I give him the pizza. I give him his change. And then he tells me, like, I ripped him off about $50. I mean, the guy only gave me a 20, you know. So I'm arguing with him because, you know, who wouldn't argue with a guy like that? And the next thing I know, bang, he smacks me right in the head. But, you know, you guys know I used to be a boxer, so, hey, you know, kicked his ass. Boom! I hit him in the head, you know. Boom! Hit him in the stomach. Boom! Hit him in the head again. You know, KO'd him. And I left off for the next job. Next thing, I got to deliver to some flats. You know what I mean? And suddenly, like, it kind of opens on its own, you know. And I'm thinking, what, did they leave the door open for me? So I kind of push it, and it swings open. Nobody in there. And I think maybe they fell asleep, you know what I mean? So I go in there, put my hand on the door, open the door, boom, a world of terror in there, you know what I mean? It's like when there's home invasions is going on, you know, there's criminals in there, and boom, suddenly they're all looking at me. I escaped with my life, lucky. But you know, I escaped only because I'm a champion runner.
Yes, and see, that film went off. It was unbelievable, you know? I've got footage here, we'll show you now, see this? There's me standing next to that actor. What's his name? That's Samuel L. Jackson. There it is. Look, there's me. I'm winning the award. So the next thing, they said, you know, I took this award-winning film to the head of SBS. It still wasn't enough to make him, like, start the series. He goes, another pilot. So I go, all right, we'll do another pilot. So here it is. You can see this was starting to get closer to the series that you actually see it now. So we'll roll the tape. Here, have a look at this. Man, I'm telling you, pizza delivery, it's the most dangerous job in the world.
Tell me how it's dangerous.
Man, you don't understand. I'm telling you, only for your own good. This area, it's full of psychos, it's full of weirdos, you know? That's why I've changed my job. That's right, today's my last day. I'm going to work in the morgue, you know? Dead people. It's got to be better than dealing with the public.
It's pizza delivering. What's going to happen?
Hey! Pizza man! You f***ing bastard! I ordered a f***ing pizza last week, and you delivered me a f***ing gherkin f***ing pizza! I ordered a f***ing seafood pizza! So now, my wife has f***ed me because of a f***ing gherkin pizza! Now, I'm going to tear you a f***ing apart!
Pizza delivery, man. It's a dangerous, dangerous business. And it was at this stage I thought to myself, well, if I want to get the authenticity of the pizza days, I'm going to have to pull in Sleek and Bobo, who was still working at the Fat Pizza Shop, mind you. Called them up, said, come in, try some acting.
When I found out I was going to be on TV, I was like, yeah! And then I was like, really cool.
Sleek was difficult, you know, he wanted to, like, he thought he was a star straight away, even before the phone call was finished.
Oh, yeah, mate! All right! I'm the king!
You know, Bobo, I mean, what's Bobo gotten on his life? He was going to give it a go. He thought it might be good promotion for his shop.
Mama!
Well, you know, I'm the shy type, so, you know, I backed away from it for a while and Paulie kept at me and saying, you know, good idea.
Shut up!
And then we did this pilot. I'm not going to show you the whole thing. I'll just show you some snippets. This is the very first formings of the show. Have a look at this. Oh, by the way, I didn't get to ask your name before. What's your name?
They call me Sleek.
What, Sleek? Well, what do you mean?
Sleek. It's my rap name. I'm a rapper, man.
Did you say Sleek?
Sleek.
Why Sleek?
Because I'm slicker than Sleek.
After all, but
fair enough.
Got some orders here. Get off your asses, or I'll dock you.
Right? How can you dock $3 an hour?
On the strength of that, what they call this pilot that you have just seen, you know, we got this series, you know, and I have become the producer and the director of this show and the writer too. Good for me, but you know. Sleek and Bobo, I mean, they've never really accepted that I have the talent and they are just kind of stooges that you got to put here, acting, go stand there, say this line, Sleek, say, do this, Bobo. To be honest with you, the audience, I don't like the two of them. You know what I mean? Like, what is it with Sleek and that whole, that Lebanese rapping thing? I mean, you know, this is the sneaky drug deal and this and that. I mean, I'm not into that. I'm a much more straight up and down, tip-top, honest living person. And then you got Bobo, you know. This is what hard work it is to work with these two clowns. This is, I'm just going to show you, this is Bobo. This is how many takes it takes to get the guy to say, hello, Fat Pizza. Look at this, we'll do it. Okay, this is take one.
Hello, Fat Pizza Pizzas. It's big and it's cheesy.
Bobo, mate, it's they're big and they're cheesy. Yeah, don't cough. Yeah. Don't touch your hat.
At this point, I say to Bobo, please, let's do it again, but a bit better. This is take two.
Bobo, it's they are big and they're cheesy.
Aye.
And again, I say, come on, Bobo, mate, it's not exactly right, mate. Let's do it again. This is take three.
Hello, Fat Pizza's Pizzas.
Take four.
Bobo, talk.
Take five.
Hello, Fat Pizza's Pizzas. They're big and they're cheesy.
Come on, Bobo, mate. Hey, don't touch your hat. I don't cough.
And so on and so backwards, you know, like that's how it goes. So it's very difficult to work with these two.
You're a stooge, mate. Stooge!
Why are people so unkind?
I don't think that I'm up myself because I'm rich now, you know. I get to meet a better class of chick. That never happened before.
You're a world-class boxer.
That's true.
You're a champion surfer.
That's right too.
Basically, you're a big stud.
You can't argue with the facts, can you?
I am tip-top.
Your dad probably hasn't changed at all, to be honest with you. He's still the same little Paulie, the good, wholesome little Maltese boy that I knew when I first met him. No, I can't say it's affected him at all.
Look, Paulie, I love you, man. I really do. If I ever try to tell him he gives me that you're gay thing and don't touch me, so I don't know, he might come out of the closet, he might not, but it won't change the way I feel about him. That's as a person. As a director, he lacks direction. As a producer, he's got no production. And as an actor, he can't act.
I keep telling him, look, he won't get in, see, we still have to put up with this director. You write these things, they read the scripts, there's no...
Play him more of a word, I don't care.
But we can't, man, because it's going to wreck the makeup. How many times I've got to tell you?
This camera's about to go too, because I'm going to actually have to get naked in this water. And no home videos. There's enough of them going around asleep.
What else can I say about him, mate? He's a small man beyond most words, if you know what I mean. And he's small in more ways than one, let me tell you. So, you know, he's a hard worker. He tries hard and he's a hard tryer, you know. He's a try-hard. And he's finally seeing that I'm sort of guiding him, like a Labrador. Like, it's not working on pizza. I'll say, Paulie, what about this ad-lib, or what about this line, what about this rap, or what about we change half the script to do this and that. He usually goes for it, but you just got to let him think that he thought of it. That's the key with people like that. What's going on?
Seek, this is the 10th time this week.
Rachel, what do you think of pizza? What do you saw tonight on the episodes?
Am I allowed to swear?
Yeah.
I thought it was f***ing excellent.
We'll have to beep that out, but that's okay.
I thought it was excellent. It was hilarious. I was laughing from start to finish. I'm not even a woggin. I thought it was
fun. He's got a beautiful
boy. Listen, my beautiful boy. He's a little bit naughty sometimes, but I...
Hey, I remember.
When he was a little baby, he had plenty love there.
You see, this is one of the many special effects we have on the show. Come on, I'll show you how this works.
Charlie's not a person. He's a reptile.
See this? We go for all the quality jokes on the show. Lots of, you know, this is funny, like a snake biting me on the balls. Well, it's meant to be the balls, but as you can see, the props department has got it just a little north of balls. But that's all right, we can work with that. Now, you would not see, Eddie Murphy wouldn't do this. We have four people to do that. Just checking, you want us to run up, you call this ridges.
Yep.
But it's mountain, 360 degrees straight up.
That's a one. So we'll have three chin. Where's that little foreign fella go?
Run into bullets. They're crazy.
After all these big shark stories, I think they got me scared.
I'm not scared. I'm just going in there.
This is not Sleek the Elite here.
If this was Sleek, mate, there's no way you'd get him in the harbour. But me, I'm going in. Because I'm not scared, I have no fear.
Alright, there's a bit of fear, I admit it.
Sharks!
It's tip-top.
They said special effects. I said, no, I want to do it the old-fashioned way with ropes and cuts and all that.
Go into it. And go.
Good.
Yes. Starts.
Hey, what are you doing? What are you doing? Oh, no, 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 no! Help me! Oh!
At the moment, we are doing some very safe stunts and driving and stuff like this. We show by using people like Bobo, that is, and how not to drive.
But you were saying before it was just some gratuitous blood and guts to get some ratings.
No, you misunderstood me altogether, mate. Now, that's, I was saying, that's what them other channels do. But for us, it's all about the honesty and the integrity. Because we want to get them good ideas across, man. You obviously misunderstood.
Honesty and integrity.
Yeah, I mean, I know you do a lot of big movies and that, mate, but this is television, a little bit different. So, you know.
Yeah, so.
Mate, you're crossing the line. I'm sorry, I'm not going to work with this bloke anymore.
Paul, he's a mad and crazy driver, yeah. Oh, I tell you what, he's a very reckless driver, yeah. With Paulie, it's a case of, have you driven into a Ford lately? Fail.
What was wrong with that 3-point? Tell me. Yeah, I told you about the bad stuff I had before. This is my way of dealing with the bad stuff.
Don't hit me again, Paulie. I'm
just
sorry.
Get out of it, mate, all right?
I'll never do it again.
You can't get good actors. You can't get the good crews. I wanted the blokes who shot like Terminator 4. Couldn't get them, you know. The Australian crews. You see what I mean? This bloke here, look at this. So these are probably the most Australian blokes we have in the show. It's very Australian style.
What can I do for you?
What can you do for me? Not move, how about that? And give me all the fucking money, how about that? Can you do that for me?
And it is unusual for SBS, but, you know, we had to give the Aussies a go too. That's fair enough.
Look, I'm just going to the casino for a bit, then I'm going to knock off a servo and get them smokes for you.
Get me some of those nicotine patches. I really want to give up this f***ing smoking.
You know, we try to get classy people, but the budget's just that much short. Because I'm that good a director now, and I'm at such a high level, do you think that I should just, like, forget this whole Australian thing and move to Hollywood?
Well, I mean, everything is bigger and brighter and better in Hollywood. I mean, the breasts, you know, the lips. You should go to LA, seriously, because, like, they really like the bikinis and the boobs and all that, and they understand it. Like, in Australia, they think intellectual is cool, but, I mean, that's so passé, really, isn't it, don't you think?
Oh, yeah.
It's a pizza, darling.
Now, a lot of people say to me, they say, Paulie, how do you get all these celebrities on the show? You know, what, we had that Gary Sweet. We had the Angry Anderson, Tony Barber, we had that Nick Giannopoulos, well, we got them good-looking chicks, we got the Tanya Zaettas, and we got this chick here and that chick there and this old bum there. We work with that funny bunny, that Bernard King.
Mate, I'm not scared of a pussy like you, all right? Let's fight, mate, come on!
Just relax.
Let's go, mate, come on! Let's go!
Just be cool, bruh. It's all right.
Come on, man, we got to fight. Let's do it. I thought you were the man, huh?
Well, I'm the man.
So people say to me, Paulie, how do you get them stars, you know? But the thing of it is, because they know I'm such a good director-like, they just come. These celebrities, they flock like butterflies to the light. I am the light and they are the butterfly.
My name's Richard Carter. I'm an actor. Comedian, voiceover man.
What the f*** do you think you're doing? Hey? You're driving my f***ing little girl and you're drinking f***ing beers. That tells me two f***ing things. One, you want to kill her in a smash. Or two, you want to f*** her when you're pissed.
So what do you think of the director, Paulie?
This bloke?
Yeah.
He's a turd.
Really?
Yeah.
Now you listen to me, you little prick. I'll have the cops watching you. And if you so much as blow in her ear, I'll rip your nuts off.
Total turd.
You know what to do with that book!
Man!
Left! Right! Left! Bring the shit out of yourself! See?
was the same Paulie that was... He was... Well, he was quick. Quick's good. Quick's good. And here's another one, you know. As soon as I stood next to him, short, you know, I'm standing, I'm towering over these people. I'm thinking, wow. I like the show very much. I like it.
Hey, Rubes, are you awake?
No.
What do you think of his directing style?
Directing? Is that what you do? I've worked with some great directors, and he's not one of them.
Oh. Paulie, I tell you, I reckon Dexter could have done a better job than him. Tanya, now, I tell you what, now, Tanya, now, that's something else. Tanya was very sexy, very sexy.
Right, right, and then would you do it again?
Oh, yeah. What, Tanya or the show?
He's a director?
Yeah, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought he was a bit short for a director.
Dave, can we turn the music down, mate?
I don't know where the switch is.
But with this fame, you know, it's come to jealousies, mate. I've suffered from this tall pippy syndrome in this country, you know? Because we got that popular and that good, the jealousies all come out the cup. How did you know I'd be the one?
You know, you just have to, you know, get used to that, being beautiful and a supermodel and talented and rich and famous. People just love to hate you.
Yeah, no, I understand, because I get that too now. I've been on TV.
Yeah?
Then what do they call it? The tall, you know... Tall. Was it
poppy.
Tall? Is it poppies? Okay, yeah, no, well, yeah. I don't get tall very often, but, you know, it's that thing. That's the syndrome we're talking about.
What,
it's
being short?
No, 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 about that thing where you're so talented and good-looking and that people, like, they hate you, because I understand that now. I know I'm at that level now.
Yeah, it's terrible, isn't it? And they just don't understand. But, like, when you really become a superstar like me, it gets even worse, believe me. And really? It's just terrible, yeah.
Bigger than me?
Yeah.
Gee.
Bro, I'm that huge now, like, I get offers from Hollywood and all the big rap labels in America. Like, they wanted me to rap with Eminem. I said, man, I like Smarties instead, you know, because they were there first, plus they got blue ones. And, like, Public Enemy, man, wanted me to rap. Run DMC, Madonna wanted to have one of my babies. Destiny's Child wanted me to be part of the Destiny. I got my own song, like, Drug Dependent, Speech Impediment, All You Lebs Out There, oh, yeah.
I'm really sorry,
So how do you like the octopus?
Yeah, this Tom Cruise thing, well, just on the quiet, you know, when there was problems in their marriage, it was Nicole and Baba.
And I just want to work with people around me that I can basically dictate, run over and sort of do what I want, you know what I mean? The Hollywood contracts, bullshit. So that's it, I keep it real, man, and, you know, I haven't changed.
And, you know, the whole Russell Crowe thing with Meg Ryan, huh? What can I tell you? And Julia Roberts, hey, baby. There's a whole string of them, and it's all good.
So I shit in this talent, do you know what I'm saying? It's the pussy I reject that makes mine the best. All of that stuff, it's all true. And, like, you can't keep a good lip down forever, man. You know what I mean? I got my own sound, I walk in leaps and bounds. And I'm quite profound, and I'm very well aware of it. But anyway, we'll get them. Peace up. We were winning the ratings, you know? We were coming number one every week. And what happened then? They changed the rating systems. Before this Aussie JTAM come in, you know, we were number one every week. Number one every page. Number one, pizza number one, 6 billion people watching in Australia. OzTAM. Aussie JTAM. You know, like, the name says it all. It's obviously designed so that chocos don't get good ratings, you know? Aussie TAM? What, it's not Leb TAM, is it, you know? It's not Choco TAM, it's Oz TAM. We can read the writing between the lines.
If you need somebody, I could be a contestical.
No, sorry, it's a Christian dating show.
Is there a difference between Catholic and Christians?
Do I have to call security?
I know it's because I'm Chocker.
But this Chocky, anti-Chocky conspiracy has gone all the way through. Like, we went to them Logies, all right? We went down there. You know? We was nominated for, like, all the categories.
A big man hooked up these fake tickets to the Logies. Get the fake tickets. Give me a look.
Yeah.
Today. Don't tell no one, man. It's supposed to be real.
See, that's the thing, you know, because they wouldn't let us in because we're Chocos.
Chocos and that, you know?
So we printed our own. And see, these Habib has supplied these as well.
Slick, it's Habib, bro. Listen, I've got to tell you something about that bird, man. I put some cocaine up its ass, mate. Yeah, that's right, mate. I didn't know where else to put it. The cops have been on my back.
Are these candies or are they something?
Like, Eckies, bro.
Come on,
hey,
mate.
That's
come
enough,
on,
hey,
don't say it on television,
hey,
man.
Enough,
no,
man.
I don't give a f***.
But then at the end of the day, they only give us one nomination, best comedy. All right, you know. They obviously couldn't deal with the super success of the show. So I thought, all right, we'll get, you know. It's all.
Like piece of chicks, you know?
Barred up, they're really like, they're pumped, you know?
Yo, yeah.
Sleek is a yellow boy.
I was actually with Annalise just before.
Yeah?
She'll be a little bit late if she has to redo her hair.
What do you think about sex before marriage, you know?
Where's my lawyer? What is this? My agent!
Look, you know, you see, this is, in this documentary, I've been trying to show the difficulty that I have dealing with
your creative people.
The difficulty of dealing with yourself.
No, the issues, creative mate. People.
You've got more issues than TV Week ladies.
I keep saying to him, please do not mess with the actresses. But does he listen? He doesn't listen.
He's in self-defense, I swear to God.
But then what happens on the night? We win it. We go up and, you know, we do the, like, we pick it up and take the award and everything. On the TV, but they did some digital tricks like special effects. We weren't even there. They give it to somebody else.
I'm in Melbourne. I'm going to the Logies, mate. Smoke a few for me, mate.
Yellow boy.
No drug talk, mate. Come on.
Come on, man.
A mate of mine who's related to the guy that used to bash people with Habib, his cousin was the security at the Logies in Melbourne, and he told us that Kerry Packer, like he wasn't backing us up on the night, and that's why we didn't get the award. So I've got nothing to say really to him face to face. I hope I never have to see him face to face, although if I did, I wouldn't mind. Sorry, Kerry, you're all right, bro.
This, I'm telling you, like, now on Australian television, it was a hoax, mate. You know, like, it was like this JFK conspiracy or something like that. But we won it. We got up there, mate. It was incredible. You know, how could they do that? That's the power of the anti-Choco conspiracy that's against us.
Get on.
It was that bumpkin politician, that Pauline Danson man.
Oh, no.
Paulie. Just please don't call me, all right?
No. Please explain.
And that's why now she's got a thing for Chocos, why she hates them. Because I knocked her back. I don't know what it is, you know, maybe something to do with brown skin or something. The memories come flashing back to her.
Man, she is sicker than AIDS.
I did give her a good one, but... I pack consoles, my kids start sleeping, the left fiend. Give me a right here, right here, need them cheap, but don't you interfere, you're out of here. Now girls wanna hook me, lebos wanna fork me. But stick that phone where you feel a steady, God, I need it, used to heat it, even lead it, now it's been superseded. By the one and only, smashing, dashing, I got it like it's going out of fashion. A streakism and passion. So, yes, I have succumbed. I've let Sleek show a bit of this clip in this documentary. But I just wanted to say that, you know, like the rap music is not really my choice. I let it go through because, you know, the younger part, they seem to like this rapping. You know, I'm just not into it, mate, this rapping.
I'm better than Sleek. I rap better than him any day of the week. He's always put a shit that he's Lebanese. I got the flesh of blood, too, don't you see?
Paulie said he didn't want the raps, but I think he was a bit jealous.
Paulie's on the mic every day and every night. Sleek is a stooge, didn't you know that?
He's got hair on his back, didn't you know that?
Eventually, I think he realised that he'll never be able to rap, so he let me introduce the rapping into the show. To go crazy and get your eyesight hazy. Done as a love, that means no one pays me. The loss of joy painting once a week, I make it his ring, but most times I'm baking. It's you for a second, speak, guess you where? When you front row, take cover. I've always had a bit of a, you know, a bit of a fame problem. I've always been really well known and really sexually attractable to usually women, sometimes men. And it's just now on a bigger scale. But like I've said as well, I haven't changed, man. I haven't changed, all right? If I ignore you in the street or whatever, I mean, I always would have done that. There's a reason behind that. I'm busy or I'm thinking of a rhyme and I don't even see the fact that you're there because I'm in this thing called sleekism, mate. Sleekism. I'm in it. It's a world. I discovered it. I didn't create it. I discovered it. And I live in it. And in this world, it's just me. There's a back door I let my mates in if they got ID. And there's also like a side door for the chicks because they're on the side. But that's it. There's no one else in my world, bro. And that's how I deal with it.
I got my job from Boba, who I met rapping at Soho. Peaking because he closed the shop that weekend. Gave me a job delivering rhymes as a wife so I could be me when I rap and feel free.
When I first met Sloop, he was humble. He was a good little Lebanese boy. You know, like the ones you know, you meet in Punch Bowl and, you know, Bankstown and the like. He was just a humble, good little Lebanese boy. And I tell you, it's just gone to his head like, you've got no idea. I can't get anywhere near him these days. And I tell you, there might even be a problem getting him back on the show. Get a piece of the rule before you get a seizure. Nutritious is this treasure. Break food for your leisure.
SBS Slick's boisterous success. Another S for the sex. Look, I just want to squash all the rumours about me and Claudia. Yes, we've done it. Yes, I gave a good time. Yes, we're friends. No commitments, so yes, I'm still available. And yes, most female actors that come on the show, I let them in the side door, Slickism. Okay? Just do it, mate. GST, just.
Thank you, Slick. Thank you so much for choosing me.
You're going to be sore for days.
That is just so typical of a man, isn't it? They always say that, and no, he hasn't. We only work together, like, and that's a media thing as well, because, you know, just because we're working together doesn't mean that we're having an affair, I've had a baby, and, you know, they hassle me, Madonna, Nicolas Cage, Penelope Cruz. It's like, it's so unfair. Just let me do my job. An automatic deliverance is being charismatic, more athletic than acrobatic. Still bumps, don't want to static, but if you want to bring it on like a genie, the only wish you get is wishing that you didn't see me.
So you know, he thinks he's going to the States, he thinks he's got all these movie deals set up, and you know, he's got his own show, The Rapper. You know, he's got it all happening. That's how he thinks. But without Bobo and Paulie, Sleek's nobody.
Funny, if you knew like that I was here, and I had to do with the rap, if and you, like you're only my boss at the show.
But hey, I'm in the shop too, man.
I don't care.
Hey,
I'm going back to
just remember, mate, I created this whole thing.
You know, I've seen the interview tapes that he did, like about us.
Yeah.
And he reckons that you've changed. That's what he said.
I've changed for the better because I evolve, I get older, I get better, I get, you know, wisdom. Not like you.
No, that's not what he said to me. You've changed, like, I'm just telling you what he said, this is not what I said.
What did he say about me?
Mate, he said that the fame that's going to your head and you're thinking about doing your own show called The Rapper. Nothing to do with Fat Pizza, mate. Look, on the spot, because the camera's rolling, I want to find out if this is true, mate.
Well, look.
Because the contracts are set, mate, for the next 5 series.
Fair income series?
Yeah, mate, you signed them.
Yeah, but I was under the influence of peer pressure by you and Bobo.
Yeah, legally, mate, there's not a leg to stand on.
Crap.
Mate, the amount of fan mail that Bobo gets, you think you're famous. Bobo is he gets the most fan mail.
Bro, I might be cool, but I'm far from a fan.
No, but I'm just saying.
Yeah?
Like, he gets all the fan mail. It's all from gay people.
That's
but
good.
You know, like, that's fair enough.
We like just to reach out to all types, all people in society. We're all human, man.
That's just the millennium, you know,
human,
like,
bro.
Everyone is accepted now.
Bobo, there you are, Lola! You look better in person than you do on the internet,
Darl. I get a few letters myself, you know. Mainly complaints from the Lebanese community.
What?
Saying, well, I mean, it's wrong, but they think that I'm not portraying a good character.
But most Lebs are like the character you play on the show, aren't they? I mean, from what I can see in the newspapers and that, isn't everyone who's Lebanese in a gang or something?
We've come to Bankstown in Sydney, and we've just rounded up some of the locals. We like to go cheap on the show,
okay, Mike,
and they just happen to have some guns. This room weren't ours. And here you go. This is the kind of things we do on this show.
Boys, hop in!
Pizza. I thought pizza was like, it was like 10 toppings for the price of 7. It was wicked.
You passed Sleek with Eddie Martin.
I did. I offered my services to Pash Sleek, and it was a very enjoyable experience, let me tell you.
Sleek, what are you doing?
Do you like the atmosphere around Pizza Launch?
Very enjoyable. A lot of walks, a lot of good-looking girls. What else do you want?
Sleek is Lebanese, right? Like, did you taste all the garlic and the hummus?
I tasted the hummus.
When
he kissed me, I suddenly was in a Lebanese restaurant and everything. I got everything.
Good to hear, baby. Good to hear.
But, mate, enough was enough. I give him the Sydney King hit.
You know, like, I'm that good as a producer now, you know. Like, I have done other shows. But then other commercial channels, man, they keep stooging me, you know. Like, I don't know if you remember, because it's getting old now. Remember that show, that Big Brother show? That was my idea. I was on it. I was one of the first people on. Look, we've got the tape. I'm going to show you now what originally was that Big Brother show. Did they mention to you blokes about the toilet, the camera in the toilet?
Yeah.
Because that's...
Yeah.
They didn't tell me about that.
Oh, my gosh.
Does it bother you?
Of course it bothers me.
Why? What's the problem, man? We've all got to go.
Why are you showering in your underwear? None of the other guys
are. Let it go. Let it go.
I wasn't going to put up with them conditions like that hokey thing they came up with, you know? I can't believe... What? We've got to sleep in bunk beds, 6 guys in a room, you know? I mean, look, I'm sorry. I've got no homophobia, but still, 6 guys in a room for 3 months, come on.
What's going on, guys?
How are you?
How you doing, Paulie?
I'm good, man, I'm good.
But when I think about it, you know, it's part of the anti-Chocky conspiracy I was telling you about, you see. You know, when I think about it, there was definitely a few meetings in that when I sensed, like, a very anti-Chocky, you know, kind of thing going. Is there any ricotta cheese? Because I want to make these pastizzis.
What's the pastizzi, man?
Do you eat them for breakfast? Or
don't you know what these are? I can't believe you never heard of a pastizzi.
No.
I was the only bloke wearing a tracksuit. And, I mean, look at this skin colour, you know. It's a shade darker than Aussie Joe.
There's no gelatis here, mate. There's no canottos.
I mean, yes, we're all Australians, but why treat me like the choco?
Don't say I was a wog, but that's taking a
what's...
It looks like
you guys all just talking about me?
No, man.
We're just saying, we're looking forward to the pastizzi.
I'm feeling a bit like it's a bit unfair. Like, I went to make the bread and that, and then I've come back in, and you just tell, you know.
Have you made the
You hurt my feelings, mate. You know, first the toilet, now this.
We're not responsible for your feelings.
There's not even a cappuccino machine, and there's no TV. And I'm meant to sleep in a room, with 7 guys in bunks. What is this, mate, you know? I evict myself off, that's it. Big brother, let me out of here. Let me out. Big brother, that's it, mate. Can someone let me out now? Hello? Yeah, big brother. The big brother.
Yay!
We got the guy!
Oh, this guy!
I didn't know there was a Television Wide Australia policy until I started working in it.
This is for the pizza show on SBS, the comedy show.
Seen that show, bro?
No, sorry.
It's funny, man.
You got any ID from SBS? Whatever.
Do we have any ID from SBS?
I've got no ID.
Alright.
Is the Prime Minister in there today?
I don't think so. I think he's in Sydney.
Should have told him we'll
see this, mate. See this? They're bloody hassle us because we're chocos, mate. This car over here has been here for 10 minutes.
I'm so upset about this.
You know, did you see that Sleek, mate?
I'm going to write a letter, bro.
Why? This bloke can sit here for 2 hours. We come here for 1 minute to do our scenes. You know why? It's the conspiracy against chocos. I'm always talking about it in the show. It's part of the material.
Especially Lebanese.
That's it, mate. That's it. Look at this car. It comes with this car, protective service.
Get in and drive
As if you have to be protected against guys like us, mate. Look at us. We're nice guys, you know. Yes, I can do boxing and that, but there's no need for protective services. Look at him, mate, but he's talking to our assistant now. Look at him. He's going to check the ID. What a stooge, mate. Just look at the big ears on the guy. It must be a prerequisite to get into the special forces they have. Big ears, mate. No training, no military skills, just big ears, man. Don't you think?
Yeah, well, that's why I couldn't get him, bro.
You know, when we make these shows, people say, Paulie, do you have a social conscience? Because the little kids are watching.
Oh, bring it on! Bring it on! Oh, will you kids shut the up?
And I mean, when people ask me that, I say, mate, haven't you seen the show?
You!
What are you doing, mate? Because, you know, when we show something like this...
Such a stooge, man.
It's obviously designed to educate the children, you know, to the negativity of different things. Yes, we show drug use. I have it in there to show what bums these people are who use them. You should not use drugs, that's right. I mean, only stooges would.
Vision, dreams of passion. Then all the while I think of you. A very strange reaction. The more I see, the more I do. Baby.
I don't want to talk about Sleek and that whole thing.
No, that's one thing that I will not stand for, and that's drug use.
Don't worry,
naked women and running about and sex, not me.
I'm trying to introduce good values, you know? Like, quite often on the show, you'll see a scene like with myself doing this. That's some good old-fashioned values of defend yourself. Because, I mean, look, you know, we're going to have all these new-age sensitive guys running around, you know? What's going to happen then? You know, what happens if an army comes to Australia and everyone's like the new-age sensitive guy? If there's no chocos who are prepared to get the club lock out when the stuff goes down, I mean, what's going to happen? Because I've got to get that back into the mainstream, that psychological, that macho, that old-style 70s macho that is gone. And I'm talking that 70s macho like Clint Eastwood and Charles Bronson had, like the tough style, cobra macho.
Well, the fine world, you know, it's a part of my makeup. You know, violence is good. You know, it's a part of everyday life, and only the strong survive. I've got this rage that burns deep inside, and I've got no control. As a matter of fact, I don't even know I'm doing it. I just think it could be childhood something or other. Like, I'm certainly not mad.
Well, Doctor, what do you think? Am I crazy?
Hey, bye-bye, check that out, mate.
I mean, look, you know, it's not cruelty to animals what Bobo was doing. I mean, there are feral animals in Australia. They have to be, what's that word they use, that culled, as they say it's culled? You have to. There's too many animals, otherwise what? We're going to have this overpopulation of animals and you won't be able to get a bloody cappuccino, there'll be a sheep sitting there. I mean, look, we've even gone as far as to do a bit of, like, accurate historical stuff. Look, I'm going to show this film here.
Schlagen des Handzeichens, Herrn Maskurenze. Dann kann mein Sein geworden.
my grandfather, he beat that Hitler up, mate. You see? And that's what started the whole thing. That's historical. You know, I'm just trying to make people aware, as I do with the whole show. And I come under criticism all the time. Oh, it's fantastical, this show, you know? It's just the stereotypes and, you know, like, it's unfair. And, you know, it's non-representational and all this. Mate, that's what you get for speaking the truth. It's very sad.
Don't you know this is the f***ing Prime Minister that gave us the BST tax?
This isn't the Prime Minister that put the flight path over Marrickville, is it?
Yeah, that's the f***ing down there.
Man, look, I've got to apologise. I'm sorry. Take the gun back. Go shoot him, mate.
So, you know, we're doing all these big things, you know, we're doing, like, this stage show, and we're selling them T-shirts, w.fatpizza.com, which only costs $30 and you should buy them. Very cheap, they're good shirts, mate.
Hats too!
You know, we're going to make this movie, w.fatpizza.com. I'm just throwing that in. All right, sorry, yeah, come on. You know, what's wrong with them buying a few T-shirts, mate? You can look just like one of us.
Internet. All right, internet. Internet.
So there's lots of big things happening, you know. It's just going off. And it's thanks to you, the people who recognise the reality that we portray on the show.
You're nobody till somebody loves you. You're nobody till...
What'd you love about the show, man?
The whole thing, man. It was the best I've ever seen.
You may be king, you may possess...
Oh, insane, I loved it. Fully sing.
And it's gold, but gold won't bring you happiness.
Oh, Sleek, he's so hot, man. He's, like, fully hot. He's fully sick.
Fully sick!
Oh, he's so hot. And Paulie, and Habib.
He's gorgeous.
And Rocky, and George, and all of them.
Yeah, they're all gorgeous.
The show rocks.
As sure.
I love her.
Shine above.
Sex, violence, and comedy.
Somebody loves you.
Plenty walks, pizza.
Yourself somebody to love.